Hello everyone, my name is Max and today I'm going to show you in my first tutorial how to make a 2D map for your game. There are two ways to do this. I'm going to show you both ways and tell you for each one the pros and the cons. Let's not waste any time and let's get right into it. The first way to make a 2D map for your game is a tile map. Tile maps are usually used with pixel art because they fit the theme of the squares a little bit better, but technically you can do tile maps with any sort of art. To create a tilemap, you just have to right-click, go into 2D object, and then tilemap. If you want, you can also experiment with other type of tilemaps like hexagonal or isometric, but today I'm just going to show you the square one. So when you create your tilemap, you're going to automatically get a grid created with a basic tilemap inside. To start adding tiles to your tilemap, you want to go to Window, 2D, Tile Palette. Now you can drag this tile palette right next to your game and scene if you want, or you can put it anywhere you want. Then you want to hit here, create new palette, call it what you want. I'm just going to leave this name, grid rectangle, because I use the normal tilemap, and cell size automatic, or you can change it to whatever you want, but one by one is usually what we use. Then you hit create and just select a folder. Now your palette should be created. To add tiles to your palette, you just have to drag them in and choose the spot where you want them to be, and then choose a name for the file, the asset file. So here I'm going to add the floor of cobblestone, then I'm going to add the bushes, but as you can see the bushes are really really small. That's because they are 32 by 32 and I set the pixel unit to 100. So I need to set the pixel unit to 32, so they are 1 unit wide. And now it's the cobblestone, that's way too big because it's 1024 by 1024 and it's pixel per unit 102. So if you can, try to take tiles that are each the same size so they fit better together, but for this tutorial I'm just going to set this to 1024, and there you go, they are now the same size. Usually you just set the pixel per unit to the size of the file if you're doing a 1x1 tile map. If you have an object that you want to put in your map that's more than 1x1, you might want to cut it into multiple pieces. That's one of the downsides of the tilemap that we're going to talk about later. So for example, here I have a lamp and I want to put the bottom at the bottom and then the top at the top. Once again, I need to change the pixel per unit. And there you go, now it looks fine. Once you have your tile palette filled, you can put it to the side or you can also keep it there, but if you don't want to switch between them, you can just put it to the side, it's easier. Then all you have to do is click the tile that you want to draw with and click and draw to put them in your map. You can also use some tools like the square tool so you don't have to draw big surfaces. And of course the eraser if you want to erase something. Okay, so now let's say I want to add a lamp or a bush, but I want this lamp or bush to have a collider. I cannot put it on the same tile map, not only because it would erase the cobblestone behind it, and it would look bad, and also if I put a collider, it puts it on the entire tile map. So I have to put another tile map for the collider objects. To do this, all I have to do is right click on the grid, 2D object, tile map. And if you don't want to get confused, you can rename it to collision tile map. Now, with this tilemap selected, I can draw my lamps by putting in the two parts, and I can also draw my bushes. And as you can see, they don't erase the cobblestone behind it. Now, if I want to add collisions to these objects, I can just click Add Component with the tilemap selected, and add a tilemap collider 2D. And as you can see, it automatically adds a collider to the shape of the sprites. Okay, so now I'm going to put a basic player in the map so you can see how the collision works. So to do this, I just drag my player in. Of course I will need to reduce the size. Make sure if you add your player in your map that the ordering layer is higher than your tilemap. So as you can see, my tilemap is at 0. If I keep the player at 0, sometimes it might not show, so I need to put it at least at 1 to make sure that it's always over the map. Now I'm going to give this player a rigid body 2D to allow it to move in collision with objects, and of course give it also a box collider 2D so that it can collision with the objects. Now I'm going to write a quick player controller so that I can move the player around and test the collisions. Okay, so here is the code for the player controller. I'm not going to explain much about it because there's a lot of videos already out there that explains it very well. So basically you just have a rigid body and you take the input and move the rigid body. Now you put that player controller on your player and set the speed to something like 100 and then you can try to play, see how it goes. Now something weird already you'll see, the player automatically goes down. That's because the gravity scale on a rigid body is set to 1. If you're doing a top view like I am here, you need to set it to 0. If you're doing a side view, then you might want to leave it to 1. Okay, so now that the gravity is disabled, the movement works fine, but that's not what we're here to test, we're here to test the map. But as you can see, there is something strange going on. I can hit the objects, but I don't see them. Why is that? Well, it's because they're both on the same order and layer. This one and this one are both in 0. So if I set this one to 1, then it goes over it. That's obviously what we want. And now we have to set the player to 2 to make sure it goes over this. Now as you can see, we can hit a collision with the lamps and the bushes. It makes our player turn, so to fix that all we have to do is go in constraint in the rigid body and freeze the rotation Z. As you can see, the collision works fine, but sometimes you'll have bugs that if you go down while hugging a wall or a bunch of objects like this, sometimes you'll get stuck into it, like between two bushes. The easy way to fix that is to go in the tilemap collider 2D, check use by composite, and then add a composite collider 2D. So that will make it so that the objects collider are linked together instead of being one collider per object, and that it decreases the chance that you get stuck between objects. Just remember that if you use a composite collider for your tilemap, it is also going to add a rigid body 2D to it, which means that if you don't want your objects to fall on your map, for example if you're doing a top-down, you need to set the gravity scale to 0. And if you don't want your objects to be able to be pushed, you need to freeze their position and rotation. Like this. Go in constraint in the rigid body and check them all. And now you cannot push them anymore. The pros of using tilemaps is that it's really fast and easy. It also makes the colliders for you, so you don't have to worry about making the colliders. And it can be easily generated and edited with code. So if you want to make a game that generates random dungeons or something like that, you would probably prefer to do it with tilemaps. The downside of tilemaps is that it takes a lot of resources, so it can get laggy, especially if you have a big map, because each tile has a position, a rotation, a sprite, and everything like that, so it takes a lot of memory and a lot of CPU to be able to run big maps. Another downside of the tilemap is that it can be hard to place big objects. As you can see here, the lamp, if I wanted to place it in the tilemap, I had to put it in two parts. Now if you want to make, let's say, a house, well, you don't really want to put it into 20 parts or something like that and put each one by one. It can get pretty annoying. And if you want to put the big objects outside the tilemap, it can create issues sometimes. So in my opinion, you should use tilemaps if you want to generate or edit your map. If your map is going to be static, you probably should not use tilemaps. The other method that you can use to make a 2D map is by using a single sprite and repeating it. So for example, here I have a grass sprite. If I put it in my world, as you can see, it is pretty small. And obviously, you don't want to have to duplicate it and move it every time, because then you end up doing the same thing as a tile map. So instead, what you can do is go into grass, go into draw mode, and select tiled. And now you can simply increase the width and the height, and it's going to repeat the pattern of the sprite while keeping it in one game object. The advantage of doing this instead of putting a tilemap and doing a square is that a tilemap with a square is going to have like 100 tiles, with each with a position and a sprite and all that stuff, while this one here has one sprite, one position, and it's just repeated over a large area. Now let's say I want to put a dirt path over this grass. I can just drag in my dirt, I put order in layer 1 to make sure it's over it, I set it to tile, I increase the width, and there you go, I have a dirt path over my grass. Let's make a quick little scene so I can show you how to do the collisions. The tile functions can also work for other objects, even if they're not one by one or made for the ground or something like that. So for example, here I have a bush, I set the order layer at 2 to make sure it goes over everything. And now I just have to set the draw mode to tiled, and I can increase the width and it's going to duplicate my bush. I can also do it with a rock by putting it here, order in layer 2. Now I set it to tile and I increase the height. And there you go, I have a wall of bush and of rocks. If you don't want to have this gap between the rocks, one way that I found to fix this is to duplicate your wall and then increase it a little bit in height so that it goes over the others. But as you can see, it cannot always work perfectly. Okay, now let's add the collisions. One way to do this would be to select, for example, the rocks here and add a box collider. And then I just have to set the size of the box collider so that it matches with my rocks. Another way to do the collisions is if you know that the player is not going to reach the other side of the objects, let's say it's the edge of your map, you can also just create an empty game object, add the edge collider 2D, and then change the edge so that they follow the edge of your bushes or whatever you have for collisions. So as you can see, the collisions for the rocks work perfectly. And now let's try the bushes with the edge collider, and as you can see, it works just fine. So the pros of using tiled sprites inside of tilemap is that it's much more efficient because you have much less game objects with less transforms and sprites. Another good thing about this method of making maps is that you can easily add big objects simply by dragging them in your scene, and you don't have to worry about putting them in multiple parts. The downsides of this method is that the maps are pretty hard to generate and edit. So for example, if I want to add a path right here, it can be pretty hard to do that with code. Another downside is that you have to manage the colliders yourself to make sure that the player can't go in through anything that you add. So overall, I would say use this method if you have a static map and something that's not going to be generated or edited, and use the tilemap if you want to add something that's generated or that you're going to edit or let the player edit.